There's Pete. I wonder if he's gone in yet.
What's up, guys?
Fancy neighborhood, man.
I know. What do you think, huh?
You know what I think? First impression, looks good from the outside.
I like it.
I mean, you know, we got some dead grass issues and whatnot, but...
What's the story on this place?
Okay, check it out. I picked it up for $899, which is, as you know, a pretty sweet deal. I mean,
pretty good.
I've got comps in this neighborhood going up to 1213, but it's not in the best condition.
Yikes.
I mean, I need your help. I really do. You guys are really good at this kind of stuff.
The neighborhood has me sold.
For this area and this house, it's going to have to be high design.
This key doesn't even work, man.
Well,
use force.
This is...
There you go. You almost fell. Wow, nice entry. Cosmetically, it's just dirty. I mean, the windows are good. The railing's decent. What in the world happened here? There's gonna be a lot of work here.
No, I know. Ooh. I know. That's why you guys are here.
Well, this is really bad.
All the flooring's gone. The walls are taken apart. What could cause someone to have to take off the drywall in the living room as well as in the family room?
Well, that would be a flood.
It's a flood.
There's a flood.
I thought at least we were gonna walk into a decent kitchen, though.
It's gonna run at least 60 grand to do a custom kitchen in here.
You know how expensive it's gonna be to redo this entire house?
So you know what? First impression of the backyard, it's actually nice. Has nice hardscaping.
I mean, it's about a 6.5 out of 10 out here.
Right.
Everything just looks peach. Nothing, the house is peach, the concrete's peach, the pool's peach. There's no contrast.
Yeah, you could probably, I mean.
Well, don't forget, if you're trying to list it for $1.2 million, $1.3 million, it's gonna have to look a lot better than this.
Right. There's a lot of potential here, but I'm starting to worry about what it might cost to do this flip right. Right now, I'm kind of up in the air. What are you thinking?
I mean, I totally agree. I would love to do this project. I think it would be super fun. This house could look amazing with the right design choices.
It's day one and we're ready to work. After adding up all of the work that has to be done with this flip, the rehab budget went up to $140,000. It's gonna take 12 weeks to get all of this construction done, so we better get started.
Say hello to my little friend.
Make sure there's no
else.
Nice and dirty.
Oh! Fire, Steve! Man, I got fire right here, dude.
Steve, is it out?
Right inside her, dude, one more.
Christina and I are partnering with our friend Pete to flip a $900,000 house in Anaheim Hills, California. And we just had an electrical fire. It seems like the outlet was damaged in the previous flood, and it short-circuited when we were testing the switches.
They got two wires that touched each other. You know, obviously sparked, caused a little fire. I think it's pretty well isolated just to this outlet.
There's no problem with the electrical system in this house. It was just this one electrical outlet that had a short, and we're replacing it. Simple fix. Now we can continue a demo and get this house back into shape.
House is back together, so we need to come up with the design for this house. Are we going contemporary or traditional?
I was thinking here probably more along the lines of a Tuscan-style home. I think when you drive up, the exterior of the house has that Tuscan vibe, so I think that we can incorporate kind of the rocks and the stone from the entrance into the inside.
You know, one thing we've never done is real solid wood doors, real solid basing and casing. Maybe we can do some type of a real solid wood, maybe an alder.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
That would work.
I think really important here is a large island. I think it should be a big rectangle and not this awkward shape.
Okay, and for the floors? If we did a Versailles pattern travertine, what do you think?
I agree. I kind of think that the whole downstairs should be Versailles pattern travertine. These cabinets and these vanity tops are not million-dollar material. We cannot keep these. The whole design, it just looks dated. I think if we're trying to get that much money, we need to start over. I think we should do the same cabinets and countertops that we do in the kitchen.
Uh-huh.
And then the flooring could be a light to medium. I think run travertine all throughout, including going all the way up the shower walls. So it kind of has that spa-like feel. And then we can do a brand new soaker tub right here.
Okay, so pretty much we're starting over here. Everything will be brand new.
I think definitely the most money should be spent master bath and kitchen.
Right.
So far, we've spent $157,000 renovating this property. And now we're trying to convince Pete that we need to spend 20 grand on landscaping.
You're telling me to go with it, right?
Well, hopefully the 20 grand will bring back 40 grand. So it's an investment.
I have to admit, I brought you in to make this house look nice, so I can't be too mad. You guys are the experts, and I want this house to sell, so, well, I mean, I guess we go with it.
And then this is what it's gonna take to sell the house.
Okay, I think a great idea in here is to add some beams on the ceiling. It'll really tie in that Tuscan look that we're going for.
We're already 12 weeks into this flip, but we keep having new ideas that affect our timeline and budget. We have to do everything we can to make this house stand out amongst the rest.
How much would that be?
Probably about $1,000 a beam.
I just don't see where putting that money in beams is gonna help sell the house.
All those small details that make you fall in love with the house and make you wanna buy it.
Again, I'm gonna go with you guys.
We're adding 3 beams to the living room ceiling. And we decided to add a wood treatment to the ceiling in the entryway to make it look dramatic.
I really love the way this is coming together.
So what do you think about the beams?
I love the beams.
You think it was worth the extra money?
I definitely do, because it adds that extra wow factor that we're looking for. But it seems like we're a bit behind.
Don't worry, once we get the TV up with the cabinets, I mean, this house is just gonna be unreal.
Okay, so when we bought the house, the comps were 1.1 million to 1.3 million. It took so long to do this project, it might have been a blessing in disguise, because now they're 1.2 to 1.471.
Wow.
So based on those comps, I would say we can list anywhere from 1,350,000 to 1,399,000.
Definitely thinking 1,399.
Right. In my opinion, a buyer's gonna come in here and just absolutely fall in love. And I think at the 1,399 list price, we're gonna get offers. All right, we are open for business.
Oh, this is beautiful.
I love the rocks right up there.
Looks like a castle.
The archway is really nice. Hi.
Hello.
How you doing?
Good.
It's a 5-bedroom, 4.5-bath home. We just finished completely remodeling it, asking $1,399,000. We'd love for you guys to take a look around and let us know what you think about the remodel as well as the price.
Look at how open it is with the light.
This is all high end. I mean, they did a really good job. This kitchen is unbelievable. The counter space, look at that. The kitchen's right open to the family room. That's
right.
Great.
Hey, open beam ceiling, you gotta love it. It
looks like you're in a lodge.
And then they've got the same cabinet.
Oh yeah, and the same countertop too. So it all ties into the kitchen.
This is absolutely gorgeous. It's a paradise back here.
Very nice.
And the jacuzzi, looks like it's all brand new. This is really nice.
Look at the wrought iron work up on those windows.
Oh gosh, that's beautiful.
Oh my goodness, this is a master bedroom?
Oh wow.
Oh my God, the archway. That gives it that feeling of majesty.
Check out how this is the same cabinets.
Oh yeah, same countertop.
And then you've got the diamond pattern here.
The same stone.
Same stone.
As downstairs, it brings it all together.
Hi, so what do you guys think?
Oh my gosh. I love how everything matched, the countertops and the wood and the details on that stuff.
And all the appliances are high end and all the workmanship was really top notch.
After a month on the market, our huge investment of time and money finally paid off. We accepted an offer of $1.4 million and we're currently in escrow. If this deal goes through, after deducting all of the expenses and splitting the profit with Pete, we stand to take home over $130,000. Time to find another house to flip.